Hi guys, it's Ren, the math person. Before we get started, make sure you hit that subscribe button. If you don't want to be bombarded with all these new videos, make sure you turn off that notification. Other than that, let's just dive right into this question. In this video, I'll be going over question 95 on SO exam P. So pause the video real quick and try this problem yourself. Okay, assuming you're attentive, let's just dive right in. So we know by definition the moment generating function of m of x given of t is equal to the expected value of e to the tx. So if we're asked to find the moment generating function of m of t1, t2 of w and z, that's basically just saying m of w and z of t1 and t2. So putting it back in our formula here, this is equal to the expected value. And we also know that these are independent. So by independency, we can actually just multiply them together. So expected value of t, in our case, it would be t1 of w. X would be w, so that's going to be equal to wt1. And because we know these are independent, we can actually multiply these together. X with the value of dt2. And we can actually put these together as well because of independency. So this is equal to the X value of e to wt1 plus z to t2. Okay, so then, and we also know that w is equal to x plus y here, and z is equal to y minus x, so putting those in there, you get e to the t1 x plus y plus t2 times z, which is y minus x. Okay. And then so basically from here, the problem is just about simplifying, and can you simplify correctly? Okay, so yt2, distributing those here, yt2 minus xt2. And we do know what the moment generating functions for x and y. We know that for m of x of t, this is equal to the expected value of t squared over 2. And then for expected value of y, it's the same thing. They both carry the same moment generating function, e to the t squared over 2. So we basically want to put these in terms of x's and y's. So then we can actually factor out, put the x's together, so you get x factoring out here, it's going to be these two terms, t1 minus t2, plus y factoring out will be these two terms here, t2 plus t1. This should be t1, by the way. Okay, and then by the definition of just adding these, we know that this is equal to e to the x times e to the y. So we can split them up, e expected value of e to the t1 minus t2, x times e to the t1 plus t2 y. Again, by independency, we can actually split this up again, e to the t1 minus t2 x times expected value of e to the t2 plus t1 y. Okay, now basically it follows this formula, right? This formula, where t in our case, right, will just be this value here, t1 minus t2 x. So then this is equal to, just plugging t1 minus t2 for the value of t, you get e to the t1 minus t2 squared over x squared divided by 2 times x with value of t1 plus t2 divided by 2, this whole thing squared. Pulling the 1 half here, I'm going to multiply this factor out, so you're going to get t1 squared minus 2t1 minus 2t1 t2 plus t2 squared times e to the 1 half t1 squared plus 2 times t1 t2 plus t2 squared. Again, because they have the same base, we can actually put them together, so you get e to the 1 half. All of these terms have a half, so we can actually factor the half out. And you get t1 squared minus 2t1 t2 plus t2 squared plus t1 squared plus 2t1 t2 plus t2 squared. Ooh, baby, that's a mouthful. But you can see that these two terms here are going to cancel out. And you get e to the 1 half. And t1 squared, there's actually two of them. So 2t1 squared plus, and then there's also 2 of the t2 squared as well, 2t2 squared. So this is finally equal to x with the value of t1 squared plus t2 squared, which is our answer, E. If you guys have any questions, feel free to leave them down below. Otherwise, as always, make sure you like, subscribe, and share. Bye!